يا الله
In one of the cities that I lived in, there was a brother who was so committed to coming to the masjid. It was unbelievable. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. He's always in the first row, not second, not third, always in the first row. He always makes it to the masjid regardless of the weather. Tornado, blizzard, thunderstorm, he's always there. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. What makes it even more interesting is that he does not have a car. He does not use like a bus pass to go to the masjid. And he doesn't even have a bike or a scooter. He simply walks there. Now, after some time, we noticed that that brother stopped coming to the masjid, and I realized that brother must perhaps be very, very sick. So I immediately went to his house to go and see him and check on him as a brother. This is the duty of a brother over a brother. So I knocked on his house, and he opened the door, and I was happy to see him standing nice and healthy. And I said, "Assalamu alaikum," and he said, "What the F do you want?" He cursed a big word, and I was really shocked. Why would you behave like that? You should supposed to be, you say, wa alaykum as-salam. But the brother said, what do you want? I'm like, I came to check on you, see everything is fine with you, because I haven't seen you in the masjid for a few days. He's like, you know what? I'm nice and healthy, right? Okay, good for you. Now move on in life. Move, Majid. Then I'm like, subhanAllah, but brother, what happened? Like, how can I help? You know, you don't look like you're in the best shape. What's going on? Anything that hurt you, maybe can support you. He's like, whatever, man. I'm like, please. He's like, okay, come, let me tell you what happened. So he takes me to the basement, to the lower level of his house, and he starts explaining. He's like, for the past 6 months, I've been going to the masjid, praying first row in every salah possible. No matter what the weather is like, thunderstorm, blizzard, tornado, I'm always there. I got no car, no bike, no scooter. I simply walk all the way to the masjid. For 6 months, I've been making dua to Allah, all kinds of dua. Not a single one of them has been responded to by Allah. Why shall I worship him after all that work? I was so shocked to hear this. I was really sad to hear this. And I told him, brother, haven't you heard of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? When he said that whenever a Muslim makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of three things happen. He's like, what? I'm like, when you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, number one, Allah would make that dua which he asked for actually come to reality. So if you're always making dua to Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, please help cure my friend who's very sick. Number one, Allah would cure your friend who is sick because of your dua. Your dua is risen and Allah brings the cure down to your friend or your brother. If Allah doesn't do number one to you, then number two, what Allah would do, Allah will not accept your dua in terms of curing your friend. But number two, Allah will lift the hardship that was about to fall upon you. But because of your dua, Allah lifts that hardship. Number three, if Allah doesn't give you number one or two, then number three, Allah will save the reward of the dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow you to taste the sweetness of the dua when? On Yawm al-Qiyamah, when you see all these dua that were not accepted in dunya, transformed into hasanat on Yawm al-Qiyamah. When the Prophet, brothers and sisters, when the Prophet said this to the Sahaba, you know how the Sahaba felt? They were like thinking and they were so amazed by this. And he said, even nukthir, then we will never stop making dua. It's a win-win-win situation. What do you think Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said? And don't forget, this is sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did he say, oh sahaba, don't exaggerate, don't ask Allah too many things? No. The Prophet said, Allahu akthar. Allah will continue to give. Allah will continue to respond. Allah will always give you whatever is best for you whenever you ask Him. And you just keep asking and Allah loves it. Allahu Akbar. So this is our attitude. From now on, you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you know it's done, it's over. Allah will respond to it. How? Which one of the three? Allahu A'lam. Okay, which one of the three is the best thing? The best one out of the three is whatever Allah sees is best for you. Barakallah feekum. I hope this was of a great benefit. Oh.